You're looking at California State Polytechnic University, Pomona, also known as Cal Poly Pomona. Over 20,000 students attend this primarily undergraduate university, which is located at the nexus of Los Angeles, Orange, and San Bernardino counties in sunny Southern California. Cal Poly Pomona has a learn by doing philosophy, which emphasizes the importance of hands-on learning. Hi, everyone. My name is Paul Nissenson. I'm a professor in the Mechanical Engineering Department here at Cal Poly Pomona. I want to welcome you to this 10-week online course. In this course, you'll be learning the fundamentals of computer programming using the Visual Basic for Applications language, which is called VBA for short. This language is embedded in Excel and other Microsoft Office products, such as Word and PowerPoint. If you have zero experience with programming or engineering, don't worry about it. I'll be teaching this course assuming you have no background in these areas. There are many computer programming languages out there. You may have heard of C, C++, Java, Fortran, MATLAB, Python, Mathematica, and this is only a tiny fraction of the languages that are commonly used. Now, every language has pros and cons. For example, Fortran, which is a language that I'm personally very familiar with, is a terrific language if you want to do calculations really fast. But Fortran is not a good choice if you want to make your programs look flashy and be user-friendly. Now, in this course, you'll be learning VBA. Although VBA is not the fastest language out there, it does have one great strength. It allows you to make your own programs that can interact with Excel files. Now, many companies don't use Java, Fortran, C, and so on in their day-to-day operations, but almost every workplace uses Excel, and learning VBA will allow you to apply your programming skills in your daily lives. If you spend the time necessary to learn the content in this course, the immediate benefit to you will be that you can get a lot more out of your Excel files. You'll have the ability to create your own programs that can answer pretty much any question you may have about the data stored in those files. And perhaps even more importantly, you'll be able to learn the logic behind computer programming. And this will allow you to pick up other languages much faster in the future if you want. Your first programming language is always the hardest, but the second usually takes just a fraction of the time it took you to learn the first language. I spent about 10 weeks learning my first language, which was C, when I was in college many years ago. It took me just a couple weeks to pick up VBA. The content of this course is similar to what mechanical engineering students here at Cal Poly Pomona learn in the classroom. So essentially, you're getting a university-level education for free. Now, unfortunately, all of you taking this course are not eligible to receive official Cal Poly Pomona credit. However, if you meet the criteria for passing the course, as discussed in the syllabus, you'll receive a certificate of completion from the university, and of course, you will have learned how to become a computer programmer. So let's take a look at the format of the class website. Everything you need for the course will be posted on the course website. There'll be one major topic covered each week. Every Sunday, you will receive an email when a new topic has been revealed on the left side of the screen. Let's take a look at the tasks that you'll be completing each week. First, there is a short video that provides an overview of the week's topic. Then there is a list of learning objectives. These are the concepts that you'll be learning during the week. A discussion board is available in case you have questions about the course content or if you want to give feedback about the course. Cal Poly Pomona Mechanical Engineering Student Assistance will help me and the assistant instructor, Dr. Todd Coburn, to answer your questions in a timely manner. It is my hope that you will be able to help each other on the discussion boards as well.
Explaining concepts to others is an excellent way for you to check if you really understand the material. Next, the week's learning activities are shown. I strongly suggest that you complete all 5 steps in order. In step 1, you will watch some short video tutorials. The videos introduce you to new concepts and show simple examples. In order to make sure that you understand the fundamental ideas from the video tutorials, you will take an ungraded sanity check quiz in step 2. The sanity check quiz is designed to help you identify areas that you need to improve on before tackling bigger problems. Step 3 involves combining many of the fundamental concepts together in an ungraded pre-quiz. The purpose of the pre-quiz is to help prepare you for the real graded quiz in step 4. Each graded quiz is worth 5% of your overall course score, and you are given 30 minutes to complete it. If you completed the pre-quiz successfully, the 30 minutes should be more than enough time for the real quiz. You will have until Saturday at 10:30 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time, which is the time in Los Angeles, California, to finish the real quiz. The first 4 steps are designed to teach you the rules of programming. But in order to create interesting programs, you need to apply these concepts to real-world situations. In the 5th and final step, you will apply the week's concepts to tackle a few programming problems. Unfortunately, it would be too time-consuming for us to grade the thousands of programs that all of you will be creating each week. But one of the nice things about computer programming is that you should be able to tell if you created a successful program simply by running it. On Sunday night, we will upload solutions to the class website to show you one way of solving the problems. You can learn a lot by looking at how experienced programmers organize their code.
We have a learn by doing philosophy here at Cal Poly Pomona. And in order to really understand and internalize the concepts discussed in this course, you have to put in the time necessary to learn the fundamentals and then apply them to problems. I'll be honest, this course will probably require a significant time commitment from you. Now, depending on your skill level and depending on the topic, I estimate that it'll take you anywhere from around 5 to maybe even up to 15 hours per week. And unfortunately, the only way to get good at programming is by getting your fingers dirty at the keyboard. So with that, I wish you luck, and now let's get to work.